the ileum. Anywhere else, it is either the small intestine or the jejunum. If the labeling is not good, I'll give you points for both. But if it is like, if you can see the mesentery is opened up like this, and if you have the mesenteric lymph node, then that's the jejunum here. Okay. All right. So small intestine is done. So next is the large intestine. The large intestine begins with the ascending colon, or here ascending colon, which begins at this blind end cecum. Cecum, ascending colon, transverse colon, right? And it goes down as the descending colon. Okay, descending colon. After the descending colon, in case of female cats, posterior to the uterus is the rectum here. Okay, rectum, and the anus is right at the end of the rectum here, underneath this. So anus, rectum, descending colon, transverse colon, ascending colon, and cecum. Okay? Alright. Next is what? Spleen. Spleen is... Spleen will only be on one side, okay? So if you have a structure that looks like dried blood, okay, surrounded by omentum, below the big lobe of the liver, on the right side, left side of the cat, that's the spleen. Okay, spleen. Okay, lungs. So lungs, there are seven lobes of the lungs. You may not have seen the seventh one, which is the accessory lobe, that is below the heart. Okay, the six easy ones are this. The topmost one are anterior lobes. Anterior left, right, medial left, medial right, posterior left, posterior right. Okay, so starting from the top, anterior, then medial, then posterior. And in the middle, below the heart, this, there is a small lobe hidden here, that is the accessory lobe. Okay, all right. Okay, now you will find tube-like structures going into the lungs. The biggest one will be the primary bronchus. So the trachea branches into primary bronchi. So that is, if we put a pin here, these two regions, that will be the primary bronchus here, okay? And so the primary bronchus continues here and makes another branching. This branch is the secondary bronchus, okay? If you have to find this in your cat, you have to like eat away in the tissues, or like use this kind of rope to take away some lung tissues. Then you will find secondary bronchus here, and there's a small one here. We don't want to see the tertiary one, it is too deep. Okay, so primary bronchus, secondary bronchus, small ones. Can I even point it? You see this one? This guy and this guy here. That's secondary bronchus. Okay. Alright. Layers of the heart. This is the parietal pericardium. Okay. Visceral is here attached to it. You don't have to worry about visceral. This is the parietal pericardium. The gap between parietal and visceral is called the pericardial cavity. Okay. Alright. Next, lungs, diaphragm. This is the diaphragm that separates the thoracic from the abdominal cavity. Kidneys. Okay. What you are not able to see in this cat is the renal capsule. Basically, this kidney was surrounded in a membrane which looked like this. So that is the renal capsule. Okay. Yeah, we have taken it off even here, but I see this in this list, so I'm telling you. If there is a small membrane outside the kidney, thin membrane, that's the renal capsule. All right. Now you do a dissection. The outer part is the renal cortex. The middle part is renal medulla, and the opening here is the renal papilla. Okay, this opening here is the renal papilla. All right. Capsule, cortex, medulla, papilla. Yes. Ureter is not very clear here, but you have the urinary bladder, and the tube that is going into the urinary bladder, most likely this one. This is the ureter. Okay, goes into the urinary bladder, and in case of female cats, from the urinary bladder, you have the urethra coming out here. Okay, and there is another tube next to that, which is the continuation of the body of the ureter, body of the uterus, and this is the vagina here. This tube here is called the vagina. So it is right next to the urethra here. Okay, in female cats, you have the body of the uterus, uterine horn or horn of the uterus anyway, and this structure ends here in a swelling which is called ovary. It is not very clear here because the vein has got bursted. So that's the ovary. All right, urethra, urinary bladder, ureter done, ovary done, uterus done, urethra, vagina here, male cats. Okay, so in the male cats you have the urinary bladder. The urinary bladder then opens into the urethra, and then the urethra goes like it deeper into the pubic symphysis. Posterior to the urinary bladder, you will see this two tubes coming out. So these two tubes come out from the prostate gland, go up, make a U-turn around the urinary bladder. That is the vast difference. Okay, so if we put a pin here, that's the vast difference. So the vast difference goes in into this spermatic cord. Okay, this is the vast difference goes in into the spermatic cord, and you can still see the vast difference here. This is the vast difference, and it makes like a coil structure here, and covers the epididymis. So underneath the vast difference in this region, there is this swelling. You can see a whitish tissue here. That is the epididymis. Okay, so vast difference, epididymis here. Okay, spermatic cord, it contains vast difference, blood vessels, nerves. Okay, testes, the layer of skin it is covered by is called the scrotum. And okay, you cannot see most of the urethra here. The urethra goes in deep, and you can see like a tiny part of it here, and the urethra, most likely this is the urethra, and it actually continues into the penis here. So this is the penis of the cat. Okay, I mean, if I'm using this cat, I would only use the label the urethra here, because I'm not able to see any urethra here, or I'm not sure if this is the urethra. But this is the penis here. Testes, vast difference, epididymis, spermatic cord, vast difference again here. Okay? All right.
Where specifically is
the epididymis? The epididymis is attached to the body of the testes, and on top of that you have the epididymis. So if this was the testes here, epididymis is there, and the vast difference is covering it. It's like a tiny white tissue.
Okay.
Yeah. All right. Did I skip anything here? Pulmonary trunk, parietal, cardiac, aortic arch, dorsal aorta. Okay. Did I show you the blood vessels? No. No. Okay. So we start with the aorta. This is the aorta here, right? So aorta makes an arch. This entire part is the aortic arch. If you follow the aortic arch down, it continues as the dorsal aorta. Okay, but before it forms the dorsal aorta, it makes two branches. The first branch is called the brachiocephalic artery, and the second branch is called the left subclavian artery. Okay, all right. Now you follow the brachiocephalic artery up, it forms three branches, 1, 2, 3. Third one, or the
most lateral
lateral right one, is the right subclavian artery. So the left subclavian artery arises from the aorta, and the right subclavian artery arises from the branching of brachiocephalic arteries. Yeah, I did not show it to you last time, but I can see it there now, so I am showing it. So the easiest way to see it is you have to lift the anterior vena cava up, and you can see it underneath that. Okay, so that is the right subclavian artery, and then there are other two branches. One of they go on either side of the trachea. The one that is on the right side is the right common carotid artery, and the one that is on the left side is the left common carotid artery. Okay, and this is it for the thoracic region. Now we follow the dorsal aorta. Sorry. This is the anterior vena cava, which branches into the brachiocephalic veins, right and left. Okay, anterior vena cava branches into brachiocephalic, right and left. Okay, all right, you follow the dorsal aorta down. As soon as it crosses the diaphragm, it makes two branches. The first one is the smaller branch, that's called the celiac artery. Okay, the next one is the larger branch, or the longer one, that is the cranial mesenteric artery. Supplies blood to the mesenteries.
Can you show the cephalic?
Celiac. Sorry. So this is the celiac.
What is the celiac running to you?
I think the celiac artery goes to the stomach and pancreas and spleen.
Okay.
I'm not sure though. You have to check the text, but I'm not sure. Okay.
So
Celiac, I think, goes into the stomach, spleen, maybe pancreas also, but just check in the text.
Okay.
Mesenteries supply blood vessel to the mesenteries. This is the cranial mesenteric artery.
Okay.
Cranial mesenteric artery
and
here.
Celiac.
So the first branch is celiac, second branch is cranial mesenteric artery. Okay, then you go back to the dorsal aorta, it goes down. And then it makes another branching that also goes to the mesenteries. That is the caudal mesenteric artery. So first one was cranial. The next one, which is caudal, is called caudal mesenteric artery. Okay. Now, in this region, parallel to the dorsal aorta, there is this big vein, which is the posterior vena cava. All right. Posterior vena cava. And near the kidney region, the blue one is the renal vein, and the red one here is the renal artery. Okay, so anything going in and out of the kidney is marked on the practical. The blue will be the renal vein, and pink one or the red one will be the renal artery. Okay, all right. Okay, caudal mesenteric artery, the dorsal aorta goes down and makes a fork again. The lateral ones will go into the legs, and they are called external iliac artery. Here, external iliac artery. All right, external iliac artery makes another branch and continues, and the same blood vessel continues into the thigh region, where it will be called femoral artery. Okay, femoral artery, external iliac artery, dorsal aorta.
What does it change? Is it just that branching right there? Where it's
yeah. Okay. So. If there is a pin here on the thigh region, on the artery, that's the femoral artery.
Okay.
If it is after the branching here, before the thigh, that is the external iliac artery, okay, near the ileum region. Okay, what did I miss? Hepatic portal vein. Okay, hepatic portal vein is the big yellow vein that you see coming out and going to the other lobes. This is the hepatic portal vein here. Okay. All right. So what did we not see? The three ligaments or three ducts. Hepatic duct, cystic duct, and common bile duct. Hepatic duct, cystic. Okay, let me try this gag here. If it has any.
Yeah, it helps.
Hepatic portal vein is clear. Did anyone of you find those three leg ducts in your cat?
Yeah.